How do you make a tiny human brain grown from stem cells conscious? Turns out, there's an answer now. We do know that if we pop them in computer chips and grow them for as long as 10 months or potentially 14, yeah, the guys who are selling them as a subscription model for computation actually kept them alive for 56 weeks. When disembodied, and I mean that quite literally, they only ever experience delta brainwave. They're essentially not awake nor asleep. They don't really have multiple states to cycle through. A brainstem is what allows you to have circadian rhythm, and I assume at least some of you guys have healthy circadian rhythm. I don't. This research group implanted them into the skulls and inside of the brains of mice with induced microcephaly. That's a condition that we see in humans where the brain and the skull are smaller than they should be, and it results in extreme cognitive deficits. People do frequently ask, why do they work with human brains? The answer is that there's just the most research behind the human varieties, and any data that they get out of their research is then applicable to medicine. They also used low-intensity ultrasound to help get the cells integrated and start functioning. What they found was incredible. Look at that green in the picture there. The green is going to be the brain organoid, and everything else you see are the projections from it. It's taken over so much of the function of the mouse's brain. When embodied in a mouse, our little human brain friends gain every brainwave they would need for function. This would meet the clinical definition of consciousness, which is being not unconscious. I do keep telling you guys, when someone says the word consciousness, they might mean different things. The psychological term is a sense of self, and that is a much higher bar. And while fish do perceive themselves in mirrors, my best guess is that every animal has some degree of consciousness. But what does this mean? We may have a very viable treatment for brain damage, people with traumatic brain injuries. We could take cells from you, make you your own brain organoids, and integrate them into your brain. It also means that we could potentially, for the first time ever, have a treatment for things like microcephaly, children born without major regions of their brain. We could help them recover and live relatively normal lives. Look at this mouse's brain. That is functional integration of human cells. How freaking cool is that?